Now, since they started making metal, it's TaylorMade have always used titanium but steel, and that was until the M1 came along and how you had a carbon composite crown. Well, now they've extended the fan with the M2 driver, and that also has a composite crown. Now, it looks pretty similar from the top, but actually the difference is on the sole, because the M1, as you can see here, has the two adjustable weight tracks, whereas the M2 doesn't. And pretty much this could be the shortest review in the world if I just told you that was one of the differences, and the other one was that this costs £100 less. But there's actually a little bit more to it, so let's take it on the range and see what the differences are. Now, when you put the M2 down at address, it's got the same look as the M1, which, if you're not familiar with it, it's got a white leading edge, and that's the titanium part of the head, and then the black part at the back is the carbon composite. It's got a dark face, so there's really helps with alignment. And to me, when you're looking at it at address, the back part of the head almost sort of blends out, and you're just looking at the white section, which really helps you align the club very well indeed. Apart from that, it's almost identical, apart from maybe the tune performance text. There's gold on the inside of this one and silver on the other one. I kind of notice it more on this one for some strange reason, but it doesn't make any difference, so let's see how it goes. Now, one thing I noticed when I've been testing this against the M1 is that this is a very different sound, and that's really because there's two weight tracks which are in the bottom of the M1 change the acoustics. This is a lot more solid sound, it's a lot sort of lower pitched, and I think it sounds very good as well. It's not as sort of dramatic as the M1, it's not sort of announcing you on the tee, if you like, and some people may prefer that, but really it's very good, and the feel is very good as well. And all TaylorMade drivers feel like this, and really I've been told I'm not allowed to compare it to the Ona Brona because the M2 is part of the M family, but I'm going to anyway, because it's in the same price bracket, and certainly feels and sounds a lot better than the Aeroburner driver. That performed really well in its own right, but was outperforming it, and that's because the center of gravity is 35% lower in the M2 than it was in the Aeroburner, and that's because that weight that was in the crown of the club from the titanium is now in the sole, because the carbon composite allows them to drop it. So really, I think in lots of ways this is better than the Aeroburner, because not only does it perform a little bit better, it sounds and it feels a little bit better as well. The shaft is a little bit longer than the M1 is standard, it's a quarter of an inch longer, but you can get a different shaft put in if you do go get custom fitted by TaylorMade at no extra cost, which is very nice of them. The only adjustability you do have on this is the adjustable hosel, which is the same one the TaylorMade had for quite a while now. You can go up or down 2 degrees across 3 different settings. That allows you to vary the loft. You've got sort of standard heads at 9.5 and 10.5. And really, apart from that, it's very straightforward. The sole's got the speed pocket in it, which is there to allow the face to flex a little bit more. It really just looks like the sort of filled in weight port from the M1, and I think maybe visually they could have done a little bit better than that, but it doesn't really matter again when it comes to the performance, because it's really the crown that really gives you that dramatic look. So is this better than the M1, or should you have it? Well, when I'm doing some testing here with the Skytrak launch monitor, both of these outperform the Aeroburner for me. And what I did with the shafts, I put the same shaft in both heads so I could make it a fair fight. Out of the middle, both clubs were, their longest drive was pretty much the same. So really the performance between the two was very similar. What I did find was that over a period of, 20 shots, I did this over a couple of sessions, the M1 probably was more consistently long than the M2 for me. And I think a lot of that is because the adjustable weights allow me to optimize that one to suit my swing a little bit more than this. Now, the difference was marginal. I mean, I'm talking a few yards here, but that is the difference between the M1 and the M2. So overall, this is a great driver, I think, from TaylorMade. They've got the sound and the feel right with the M1 and M2, and they've got the looks to go with it as well. The performance is excellent with both of these drivers. It's right up there with the leaders in the market. Compared to the other sort of just hosel adjusted and non-movable weight drivers, the M2, I think, stacks up very well indeed, and it's going to be an interesting to see which one comes out on top in the market. If you're going to compare to the M1, it really is going to come down to whether you are gaining significantly from the performance by having a little bit more adjustability in the head in order to suit your swing. And then if that is the case, whether or not you're willing to spend the extra £100 for you. It may be that the M2 has enough adjustability and enough forgiveness in there that you wouldn't necessarily need to do that. And of course then you'll have the benefit of a driver which looks as good as the M1, but no one will know the difference. Well, that's all for me today on the M2 driver. Let me know what you think. Please put some comments below. Thank you for watching, and for more reviews, please check out the website at golfalot.com.